my name is Shooter Hatfield. They say the confession is good for the soul. Well, I ain't admitting anything. Now, Williams, Hatfields, and McCoys have been, well, we've been feuding for the better part of 60 years. We've been hating, shooting, stealing. But in all that time, it's inevitable that a couple of us is gonna fall in love. There's perhaps no more sordid a love story than that of my cousin Rufus and his forbidden love to that beautiful and somewhat uncleanly Rapunzel McCoy. This is the story of that love and the story of Rufus's untimely demise. Try hard not to
gonna mess with our party since before it was written.
That's right. Now, you know,
Yeah, come on.
Well, Blanda Hatfield,
yeah, come on.
There's a Hatfield skunk in my family tree. And I'm fixing to shoot that pigeon out of my tree.
Rafer, you saying you shoot your own kin for marrying one of us?
Well, that makes sense. Yeah.
Well, you go right ahead. Don't stop there, y'all coon.
That's right.
Yep, there are a lot of boys need dad.
The way I takes it, there's only one way to get a stray dog out of another one's kennel.
Tell us.
Actually, there's two, but...
That's better.
That stray dog of a Rufus looks so much like his old man of a dog, Rondo.
Oh, sure.
That we're just back to that one again.
Now I know for a coon's age that Rufus has been a skimming profits from a family business.
You've been doing what?
He's been using the money for his midnight liaison for that McCoy vixen. The family could use an extra 63 cents a week.
That's right. Yeah.
Time to thicken up the gravy.
That's what I'm talking about, thick gravy.
You McCoys are a bunch of possum stewing, chicken stealing fellas that can't shoot worth a lick.
Yeah.
Except for that lovely swamp lily Rapunzel.
And you're not smart either.
Seeing as how that Rufus fella been smooching on my sister, and how he scared Grim away by saying that that precious darling Belle was engaged to some fella down in Pittsford Holler, lead poisoning a good death he deserved.
I remember what time that Rufus stole my coon traps. Just as right any good time to kill Don Hatfield.
You steal my sister and you got yourself a grave.
Right.
You know, Rufus always was a Joseph in this clan, but that don't mean that I can't take the opportunity to slay me a few Egyptians.
I was here too much besmirching the fragile state of my lonesome dog. Come away with me, my fairly well love. Let us escape this hornet's nest of intolerance.
Darling, oh my darling Rufus mine, you done heard Papa say he done shoot me if I'm go.
If I don't get you first, ain't no McCoy gonna cross these tracks in my lifetime.
Well, I guess you're gonna have a short lifetime, honey.
Slander amongst drunkards is among the worst of sins. That and leaving a gal the Possum Creek Bridge with her suitcase packed. The wage of this sin, Rufus, is death.
We have to have peace. Them two deserve each other.
He may be my brother, but I am willing to sacrifice him for the sake of our family.
I swear, my little chickpea, these is all lies and perspirations. Tain't nothing but good gonna happen to you with me.
Rapunzel, you being taken for a ride by that no good two-timing double-dealing
varmint of a cousin. If you used to leave them McCoys, come on over to me. I've been in love with you since you wrestled that boar at the county fair. You're too fine of a daisy to be in the hands of that weed-picking Rufus.
I's conflicted mighty hard, Rufus. You know that you's a burr stuck hard in my heart, but I'm afeard that
come to me, my little apple seed.
Been 60 years we've been shooting at each other. Till this moment, ain't nobody been gotten hitting. Until now.
Maybe should have mixed with them, of course.
That was good riddance to bad rubbish, is what that was.
I guess he had it coming to you.
She's all mine now.
Never done did consider him a son of mine.
Yep, no marrying happened now.
No eggs for breakfast in the morning for the McCoys.
I'm going to get some new traps.
Wait for the train to clean him up.
That was a long time coming.
No more drunken philandering by that hat field.
Where I was born and raised.